Hi everyone. So I thought I'll make a video just to catch up with you because I haven't uploaded the video on YouTube in a while and I didn't want you to think that I disappeared suddenly. We are away on holidays and I just been enjoying the sun and just doing the usual things you do and obviously my son is now just over a year and a half, and so he's enjoying running around on the grass and getting some sun and sea and all that good stuff. So today's video, predominantly, I think it paused here. Today's video, I just want to share how my art has been going on holidays because I think when you stop is when you then start struggling. So I have packed this palette with me, the Daniel Smith that you know from the previous videos which I have made myself, and these are the colors. Let me just quickly go through. It's the Indian Yellow, New Gamboge, Quinacridone Gold, Quinacridone Sienna, Pyrrole Red, Alizarin Crimson, Quinacridone Magenta, Quinacridone Violet, Quinacridone Pink, Opera Pink, and Indanthrone Blue, Prussian Blue, Sap Green, Green Gold, Rich Green Gold, Buff Titanium, Shadow Violet, Moon Glow, and then I also have a Schmincke Horadam Gold over here. So I'm filming from my camera, so the video will be a bit more wonky, and I need to make sure I have the picture or the image in the middle because otherwise it cuts off when I edit it later. So I have the palette I have composed or put together has the colors that I need. So as I said before, flowers and fashion illustrations are my two favorites, and I want to learn and I want to improve and discover my own style. Now, the first time when I just came on the holiday, which has been over a week now, almost 2 weeks or something like that, basically I then sat in the garden and I tried to paint roses because we're staying at my mum's house and her roses are beautiful, and this is what I got to draw, and these, I forgot what they're called, but these are different flowers in the corners here, but basically these three are roses. And after I went over with a pen, which is this pen here, my favorite pen, but this does move with water, so it's not what's it called? It's not permanent. Basically, after I went over with the pen, I am okay now. But before that, it just was not. Even the level, it was worse than I usually paint at home, and I felt, I don't know, something happened. I just could not get into it, which was really disappointing. So these are the Daniel Smith, and then I have found in my bedside table one of these bad boys, which I completely forgot I had. It's the St. Petersburg White Knights, or otherwise known as the Nevskaya Palitra for the Russian speakers. And this is the pocket size palette. Like I said, I completely forgot I had it, and I'm really happy because I've seen these reviewed before and they're really great if you want to take out the watercolors and put something else here. You can use this palette really well because it just comes out like this and then you just slide the pans in there. So I was, like I said, really happy to discover that because they are one of my favorites. So after Daniel Smith, I'd say these are second place for me, purely because they're just stunning. They're so vibrant and beautiful. So I've made the swatches over here. Doesn't look like there are any new colors from what I already have. I think I have all of them in my big palette at home, and so I tried to paint these flowers here. It's basically the same type as that flower. I should have really written down the name of them, but I think you know what they are. This is just the pink and then the orange. So my mom has three different types. She's into her flowers and gardening and all that. And I was better, I was okay with that because I didn't have to use any black pen to highlight anything, but still something was missing. I really, really want to have my own style and create something that I haven't seen before. I feel that almost anyone can pick up a brush and paint something like this. But just now I have sat down and painted these two ladies, and I felt inspired again and I wanted to share this with you. So I started off by, before that, I have been watching loads and loads of videos on YouTube. I am quite into, have discovered this thing called Traveler's Journal, the Hibachi or something like that it's called. So I think I will have to, once I get back home, I think I'll have to get one of those because it seems like it's something that is actually what I would need. Anyway, so I have been seeing a lot of YouTubers doing these great illustrations, and it's very sort of free, and it's combining one thing with the other, and just loved it. And I thought, okay, I just want to be able to do something creative and actually like it. And this is the first thing that I just did now that I really, really like. So what I've done here, I started just doing the flowers. These are some type of daisy or something like that. And I haven't looked at any flowers while doing these. I just seen some in my mom's garden, but I didn't really pick it to draw from life. So I just sort of did it from memory. I tried to go with colors that would go together and be also creative. So these, my mom's flowers are white, and this flower obviously has purples and pinks in there. And I think it pops really well with the color combination. So then I thought, okay, let me actually try and do something out of this. So I went ahead and tried to paint these bodies, which I think James Burke, he sort of is very inspiring because he does a similar thing where he just attaches heads or bodies, and it looks really cool. So anyways, that's what I tried to do here. I tried to put a body onto the flower, and I actually really liked it. I decided to keep, to not add any skin tone, because I want the flowers to pop and the rest to be sort of black and white, really. Again, I used this pen for details. On their faces, I have used the pyrrole red for the lips and the quinacridone sienna for the cheek. And the hair and the eyes, I have actually mixed these are all Daniel Smith we're talking about, so I've used Daniel Smith colors on this illustration. So this is Moon Glow, and this is a Nanthrone Blue, and because I don't have black, I wanted to mix the two and see what comes out. A really nice color comes out, so I quite like this combo. So that's what I use for their hair. And yeah, I'm quite happy with it. And in terms of the eyeshadow, again, I didn't want to have too much focus on that, so I just used the Buff Titanium. And the rest, like I said, I just attached legs and arms. I'm not very good at painting, so I just kind of left them as they are like this. So yeah, I think, so I also added some details, just some extra petals on this, just to break it up a little bit and have a bit more interest to these two. Which pinks I have used here? A bunch, really. I think I've used, predominantly quinacridone magenta, quinacridone violet, and quinacridone pink, mixing them sort of together, and also in Nanthrone Blue to create that purple. In terms of yellow, it was mainly Indian yellow with a little bit of new gamboge. So I think go for it. You know, if you have some sort of artistic mind block and you feel stuck and you feel quite uninspired and maybe even frustrated to go and paint something, because when you paint and you don't like it, you know, naturally you would be put off to do it. But I think just try it, watch loads of videos, get inspired by other people's work, and just go for it and see what happens. Just experiment, don't be scared to put paint. I think once you start to, well, this is what I struggled with. Once I start to narrow myself to, for example, the sketchbook that I showed you before is just flowers. So I feel, for example, I want to paint something else, but I don't want to put it in there because that's just flowers. So I think it just gets really confusing. So just use, so this actually is a Fabriano, I think, yeah, Fabriano rough watercolor paper notepad. So I can paint and just flick and whatever, it's you just combination of things. And if you start with something, just know that if you have a black pen, or this is how I feel anyway, if I have a black pen next to me that I really enjoy, that would be it. You know, I can just do corrections, add some things, and develop it into something else, because on their own, these flowers were nothing interesting. So yeah, I think I shall be doing loads of these illustrations, and hopefully I will share some of my experiences with you soon again. And yeah, hope you're having a lovely summer, and see you soon.